Hello dear friends, today we are making dal palak. The recipe is very simple and healthy too. For the details of the video, let's move to our cooking lab. To make that, I have taken 1 cup of chana dal. First we have to wash it and I'm going to pressure cook it for 10 minutes. Now the dal is cooked enough. Within 10 minutes itself, in pressure cooker, I got it ready. Keep it aside. Now I'm going to make the masala. For that, I've taken one pan and I'm adding approximately 1 tablespoon of sunflower oil and a pinch of cumin seeds, 2 red chilies, 1/4 teaspoon of hing. So we have to saute it in this oil. After that, we can add 1 chopped onion. I have taken a big onion here. Then 1 tablespoon of a pound garlic, 1 tablespoon of chopped ginger, then enough salt. We can salt all these things in this oil. Within 1 minute itself, it will be ready. Now we can start to add the spices. I have added 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1/2 teaspoon of red chili powder, 1/2 teaspoon of coriander powder, and we have to fry all these spices in this oil for a while. Otherwise it will have a raw taste. To avoid that, we have to stir it continuously for at least 1 minute and you have to keep the flame low. Now this is the time to add the tomato. I have taken 2 medium sized tomato and I cut it into small pieces, and if you want, you can make the tomato puree also. All together we have to mix, and as I am always telling, the tomato should cook, and if the tomato is not cooked enough, the curry will not be that much tasty. So that all together we have to mix, and we can cover the pan for a while. After that, the tomato pieces will get cooked enough. Now I'm going to cover the pan. Wait for 2 minutes. So after 2 minutes, you can see that the oil started to separate from the masala. That means the tomato pieces are cooked enough. And gently mash the tomato by using the spoon. So it will be in a paste-like consistency. Now this time we can add the chopped palak in it, roughly chopped palak. I have taken 1 bundle of palak and I have washed it properly and I chopped roughly, and I am adding the palak to this tomato mix. Now we have to close the pan for about 1 minute so that the palak will start to release water from that. In that water itself, palak will get cooked. After 1 minute, you can see that there is more water inside. We haven't added any water to that, but all these water came out from palak. So I'm going to once again close the pan so it will get cook enough. After 2 minutes, the palak is cooked enough and it combined beautifully with the tomato mix. So now we can add the chana dal, which was already cooked. And I'm going to add the boil, otherwise cooked chana dal, to this mix. This time you can check the salt. If you want to add more salt, you can add it. Mix all these things together. As you can see, it is in a bit thick consistency now, so that I'm going to add some hot water in it to make it bit loose. Now it is in the perfect consistency and I'm going to close the pan with the lid, and I will wait for 2 minutes to get it boil. After 2 minutes, you can see that the curry is boiling. So the gravy is in a perfect consistency. As you can see, it is not that much loose and it is not that much thick too. So everything is perfect. To increase the taste, I am going to do one more step. 1/2 teaspoon of ghee also I am adding to this. And after adding the ghee, I'm going to off the flame and I will cover the pan with the lid and I will wait for another 5 minutes. So after 5 minutes, it is ready to serve. Serve it hot with paratha, otherwise chapati, and it is very good with rice also. And please try the recipe. It is very very easy to prepare and it is very tasty and healthy too. As I'm always telling, please give your valuable feedback in the comment box. Please subscribe my channel if you haven't subscribed it yet. Keep on watching my channel. Thanks for watching.